Hello.
Hello.
Oh. Hey guys. It's Hello. Sunday.
Yeah.
And we are making our video for the week. Rue's got some snacks. Pardon. And I'm going to take you around. We did a lot up here yesterday, but we left the camera home because I didn't charge the battery, did I? So we're going to do a very quick tour. And then we're going to get on because we haven't got long here today because we're going to the park to hunt for some Pokemon and play on the park and go on the train, aren't we? Yeah?
What?
Yeah.
It's right. In a different country?
No, the train around the water park.
A wheel train?
A little mini train.
Oh.
Oh. Right, hang on, can I get up? Can I get up? Let me up, let me up. Good. As I said, Sunday the 22nd-ish of April. The plot. We've been given permission to put polythene over this edge because the weeds were getting very big and they were blowing seeds over here, which was becoming increasingly annoying. Little flower bed, looking okay. I'm going to put some sweet peas in today. And the planter that I did with the strawberries and bulbs and seeds is looking good. And if we can see, if I can show you about stabbing myself. Can you see those? This is my gooseberry bush from Aldi's. That was the red gooseberry bush. It's fruited already. I'm so proud. Got some pots of potatoes. I did a video, which I still haven't put up. There's pink fir apple, King Edward, Maris Piper and Sarpemira. And then the one in the middle is that funny shaped one that we found up here. We're doing this like a test experiment. Here we are. Oh man, I just trod on the strawberry bed. This is why you need edgings on beds. Not necessarily raised, but edges. Rue's square bed here, so that she can start planting. I think she's getting a bit twitchy. And this bed is all ready. It's all lovely. And we've got here, and they need sorting out the top. There's a row, door row this way, and a row this way. And for the, these are for French beans, and this is for the bellotto beans that are for storing. And then here, if you can see, is the canes for the runner beans. It's very sturdy. It's tied through this wire at the top, so it's still got a bit of give for the wind. So onions and garlic are doing really well. They did dry out quite a lot, I think, with this abnormally dry weather that we've been having for April. Can you see that over there? I can zoom in. There's a rogue potato. I have to grab that. But I've given them a little water, but they do seem to be doing quite well. So they'll be fine. I've got the other ones in the modules at home to plant up here as well. The brassica bed, we've uncovered it. And it's looking great, the soil is fantastic. I'm going to hoe it and keep on top of it until we plant it. But I'm actually not going to dig this bed. This is no dig because brassicas like firm soil. So I'm just going to level it out, keep hoeing it and keeping it clear. Digging out any bits of bindweed, but not doing much with that. It's all staying clear down here. I just need to do a bit more on the edge of the bed. And we've started in this area. So it's all looking good. Exposing all of the raspberry canes properly because the weeds are all in between each of the canes. So I'm slowly working through doing it properly and weeding all by hand, so that the autumn fruit and raspberries, their new shoots coming up, are not damaged by the hoe. So yeah, that's where we are at the moment. I'm gonna finish the fence hopefully today. We got rid of some of the things like the old cage and all that. I think it's starting to look like a proper allotment now. We've got this white arch off Recycle. We're going to grow the birdhouse gourds over that, so you go through here. And we've got two rows of Aaron Pilot, two rows of Maris Piper, row Sarpemira, two rows of King Edwards in, and we've got a couple more rows to go. I think that's all I've got to tell you for now. Quick whistle stop tour. It's really warm but quite breezy and nice. So I think our priority today is to tie up all the bean poles, clean up down there and get a few more fence posts in. You okay?
Yeah.
And get Rue's bed started. But I'm happy with that for a weekend's progress. You've got plenty to do at home as well. Yes. Okay. Thanks. Hi guys. We're not going to stay much longer now. Owl's nearly finished this bed. So the plan is to get that sunk into the ground, get a weed membrane in and chuck these bags of topsoil in that we picked up from someone who has had a vegetable patch and they had raised beds. So it's got manure and that mixed into it still. I've just quickly put together some P frames. That one's not secured yet, so it's an A-frame and then we put netting down the sides, and I've actually, rather than cut it off at the end, I folded it back and stapled it in, and I could put, grow a few peas at the front of it as well. So you'll have peas on either side of each of those, and we've got the frames in. They're not secured properly at the top yet. They make you feel a bit drunk. They're a bit, you know, but they'll do the job. It's not a beauty contest. This frame, I love this arch, the way it's arched, it's lovely. So what I'm going to do now is, I've tried to lay some wood down here, to put some wood down here to show people that there's a path going through. And what I'm going to do here, so these are the runner beans, obviously they're not going in for a while yet. So I've got some beetroot, which I've sown in little clusters, so they can be thinned out a bit. But there's a video I watched by Charles, not Charles Darwin, Charles Downing, the no-dig gardener. I like digging, but he basically planted his beetroot, which is there, and he did it. He sowed them all together, and then when they're growing, there will be one that will grow bigger than the others that will push one out. Then you take the big one out and the smaller ones continue to grow. So rather than growing them each individually spaced out, we just grow them like that. I thought that was genius because we don't like really big beetroots anyway. I like them more for pickling and for in salads and that. So that's how we're going to grow those. Because the soil is so bad, I've sprinkled in some compost over the top, which I'm just going to smooth out, just give them a bit of extra nutrition because the soil is so dry. Now, I've done the same here. So these are the French beans, these are cobra. I'll be growing here, up there. And so here, I'm just going to put some broad beans on the end, which I've been growing at home, just there. Now, I don't have a lot of broad beans because I think I said before, we don't really eat many. We tend to just have some in the freezer and then we chuck them into rice dishes and things like that. But we don't have many of them at all because we eat so many other beans. But I thought it'd be nice to just have some fresh ones. So I'm going to do those and I will come back and show you when I'm done. Hello.
Hi, Mummy.
Hey, darling. You okay?
Yeah.
Mind my drink? Where's my drink?
I can drink it with my mouth.
Okay. These roots look great, don't they? Okay, so just dig the hole so it's level with the soil. Just tuck it in. There we go. And I think, why am I drunk, darling? These are the same as what I'm going to direct sow. So once I do these, I'm also going to direct sow a couple of them as well. So these are broad bean masterpiece green long podded. I think they go to about 60 centimetres, so not really tall. So these will need pinching out as they grow from the top because broad beans are terrible for getting black fly, which take all the sap and juiciness out of the pods and flowers, and it can devastate the crop. So you don't have to plant them too far apart,
yep,
because they're self-supporting.
Yeah.
So they don't need a structure to climb up.
Yeah.
Because they're not climbers, they stand upright. So I'm planting these in a row about 6 inches, about 5 inches apart, and then each row about 5 inches apart again.
You're great, Mummy.
Cheers, darling. This one had an accident. I dropped something on it earlier, but I'm sure it'll carry on and grow. It'll be fine.
Yeah.
It'll be fine, won't
Hopefully.
It? Hopefully. Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed. Have beetroot over there.
I have beetroot over there. We're going to plant that where I put the compost there.
Mm-hmm. It's right on the compost bar, right, Mummy?
The beetroot is, yes. But we're going to plant it there. We've got to get a wiggle on, haven't we? So we've got to go to the park.
Yeah.
Yeah, and these need to go in today. But these ones aren't as far on, but I'm going to put them in anyway because they'll grow on nicely here. And I've still got the white one. I don't know why it's come all white. I'll see what it does. Some of them obviously were only just emerging, but I'll take that whole cell out and just put that in instead.
Mummy?
Yes?
Can I have a try?
Oh, yes. Do you want to plant this one?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Come over here.
I think I'm going to need that.
Weave it in. Right, you need to plant that in the hole. Careful.
Oopsie.
Support its roots.
Oopsie, it's breaking a little bit.
That's fine. Now scrape all the dirt back around it. Make sure it's firmed in. Firm it down. Around it. It's nice and firm in. Good job. Do you want to do the next one?
Yeah.
Get your trowel then. Dig a little hole here.
This is as far as I can go.
That's cool. That one in there. Take out that big one. Go on then. In there. Same thing. Press it in. Cool. Good job. Right then, I'm going to finish these off. Do you want to help me plant the beetroot in a minute? Yeah?
I want to watch you.
Okay, can I get back there then, please? Albino one. And now we're planting the modules where we haven't got big plants. There's a couple I should just fall it out of. Come on. There we go. There is a root. There's a nice root there. As long as it's got a root, it'll be fine.
Yeah. It'll be fine.
Keep your nose out of the camera, Missy. So that's those done. And then
I'm going to be in the back of the camera.
Okay, you're looking at the back of the camera.
There's a red light flashing in the corner.
That means it's recording. Right, so I've only got this amount left. So I am just going to push these in now. So doing the same distance. Tell you what, that rotavator really changed this ground. I'm so glad we did it. It was an expense that we wasn't planning on spending, but at the end of the day, we wouldn't have been able to get to where we are, so we've still not got the car fixed. That's turning out to be a lot more complicated than we thought. So, in fact, I'm just going to pop these last three on this end here.
Mummy.
Yes, darling.
I'm going to ask the camera something.
You're going to ask the camera something?
Guys, I've did some videos and I know I have 0 subscribers and Mummy has really loads. So, guys, I really am really impressed of Mummy, but I'm really sad of mine because I don't have any subscribers.
Wait, Rue, you don't have a channel yet, to be fair, do you? No. Okay, so Rue is going to do a channel, which is probably going to be called Rue's Ramblings, because it seems quite apt. So when she does that, I will let you know. And if you want to listen to her little videos talking about all the things that she does, and her perspective of the allotment and all that, and the artwork and sculptures that she does at home and everything, and maybe some cooking, yeah? Things like that. Then you can subscribe, which would be nice. Okay, well, you don't have to, but I'll put a post link if you want it. Okay, so they're in now, and I'm going to water them in a bit. Still having to bring water up every day because the water pot is empty because it hasn't rained in weeks and weeks and weeks, has it? Hang on, just wait a minute. So now I'm going to plant the beetroot, and I'm not going to film that. I'm just going to show it you when it's done. Okay, thanks. I've planted 5 of each 3 types of beetroot along there, and the broad beans are in there. What I haven't done is I haven't planted all my beetroot. I've saved some, and I will keep them going at home because they have been reared and have been growing outside, but we are due apparently some snow this week, and the open ground is a bit different to growing in modules at home. So yeah, could look back up. There we go, looking like an allotment. Get in there. I don't want to jinx it, but neighbour's plot. The guy doesn't live anywhere near, apparently, so if he's struggling to get up now, he's going to struggle to get up in the summer. But anyway, he's been asked about if he's going to do anything with his plot. And Al's name is on the list, that if he gives it up, then we get first refusal. So to have both sides of the path will be fantastic. There's so much more we want to do in terms of growing food to store over winter rather than just growing to eat fresh. So I would really, really welcome that. Rue's bed is constructed and we started to dig down here, but the ground is just absolutely solid. We're going to wait for a bit of rain to soften it up a bit and then come back and do that. But you can see it's been done. I know it's not a race, but I do want it to look like a working allotment rather than just a patch of empty ground. And then I feel like, when I can see structure, I feel more positive and I feel like something's been done. So, there you go. Right, we're going to go now. We are going to go to the park, and Ruby's going to run crazy for a bit. She's back at school tomorrow. So, yeah. Sorry, I'm just wondering where the robin's gone. Okay, so I'll catch up soon. I might film a bit at the park and tag that on the end, but I'll try to keep this video short today. Okay, all right, speak to you soon. Bye.
Do you know? I might play Minecraft when I Skype. Please Skype and then play Minecraft because I might be on Daddy's computer in my corner playing Minecraft. And I might show you. I might build something in Minecraft because I haven't played Minecraft in ages. So okay. Please Skype and I play Minecraft.
Okay then. All right. So see you soon.
See you soon.
Bye.